welcome to Organic Attitude. My name's Marie, and I'd like to tell you about my new favorite book. It's called Banana, The Fate of the Fruit That Changed the World, and it's written by Dan Capel. And this is a fascinating book. One of the most fascinating things is the fight that bananas have against the Panama disease right now. The first bananas that came to America were actually completely wiped out by Panama disease, and we now are eating a inferior type of banana, but it's at least it can, for the moment, fight off this Panama disease. And for us here in the West, you know, if we don't have bananas, okay, we have other fruit to eat. But in other countries, it's what they basically survive on in certain types of the year, especially in certain countries in Africa. It's one of their major food sources. So this disease is a serious problem. And this book is really fascinating. It talks all about that and how scientists have been trying to fight this Panama disease. And so when you think of the banana and you go in the grocery store and you have it, be sure to appreciate it, because it might not be around forever if we can't figure out a solution. Some more great information about this book is the wars and the conflicts and just the history that's involved with this book is crazy. I mean, people have committed suicide, governments have been overthrown, people have been enslaved, people have protested. There's been so much that has gone on behind the scenes just over bananas, and it's a fascinating history. And so also, it's really a call to action, because it helps you understand where your food comes from, and specifically the banana. It helps you understand things like why it might be a good idea to buy fair trade or organic bananas, because there's people who sometimes die or get awful diseases, cancer, because of the many, many pesticides and herbicides that are sprayed on these bananas to try and get them to grow. And so just, you know, the banana is a very mixed fruit. In some ways, there's great triumphs behind it. Like, there's varieties of bananas that have been grown in places in Africa now that are allowing people to be able to still eat the bananas. And in other ways, it's a very sad history. And so, it's just, this is a great book, and I think you'll enjoy it.